Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the Blazor Speed Dial component. This Speed Dial component is an extension of the floating action button, which displays multiple action items over the screen's content. Before proceeding, make sure that you have one of the following .NET SDKs installed in your machine. You should also have one of these IDEs installed. With that confirmed, let's start building the app. I open Visual Studio 2022 and create a new project from the project dashboard. From the list of project templates, I choose the Blazor WebAssembly app and name my project as Blazor Button. After that, I continue with the default target framework and click Create to complete the project creation. Okay, the project has been created and is ready to use. If you want to know more about Blazor WebAssembly app and how to add Syncfusion components to them, click the video link shown in the YouTube card above. Next, I will proceed to add the Blazor Speed Dial component. So, first, let me open the NuGet package manager and search for the Syncfusion Blazor Buttons package. Then, install this package in my project. Click this OK button to continue the installation process. Alright, the installation is completed, so now, let me start to use the Speed Dial component. First, I need to open the Imports Razor component and add the Syncfusion Blazor Buttons namespace to use the Speed Dial button in any of the components available in the Pages folder. Next, I am going to register the Syncfusion Blazor service. So, let me open the program CS file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then, make a call to the add Syncfusion Blazor method to register the Syncfusion Blazor services. Also, I need to register a valid trial license key in my application, so call the register license method and pass the valid trial license key here. To see where to generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Okay, next let me proceed to define CSS for the component by installing the Syncfusion Blazor themes package in the project. For that, I will navigate to the NuGet package manager and look for Syncfusion Blazor themes package. Install this package and click OK to complete the installation process. Then, open the index.html file and reference the CSS file from the installed themes package. Also, I need to add this script reference because the ignore script isolation option is set to true by default and it enables better loading performance for our app. Okay, the configuration steps are done, so now let me proceed to add the Blazor Speed Dial component. Before adding the component, I would like to explain the primary actions to be performed by the Speed Dial button in this video. You all know that CRUD operations in the data grid are primary actions. So, the idea here is to add the Speed Dial over the data grid component at the bottom right position and display the grid's CRUD operations as its action items when the Speed Dial button is clicked. To achieve this, first, I navigate to the NuGet package manager, and in the Browse tab, I search for the Blazor Grid package and install it. I click OK to complete the installation. Then, I open the imports.razor component and add the Syncfusion Blazor Grid namespace. Let's start to define the grid component. Open the index.razor component and remove the default content. As I said, I am going to define the Blazor DataGrid component, so I add the existing Blazor DataGrid code snippet here. The explanation of this code snippet is explained clearly on the Blazor DataGrid documentation page, which you can find in the description below. Also, check out the video link shown in the card above to learn more about the Blazor DataGrid component. Now, I will run this example. You can see the Blazor DataGrid component displayed with defined columns. Next, I will show you how to add the Speed Dial button over the DataGrid component. First, I include the component using the SF Speed Dial tag. Then, I define the OpenIconCSS property and assign the predefined classes, eIcons and eProperties 1, to add an icon for the speed dial component. Here, you can also set content for the component, using the content property. Next, I am going to display this speed dial in the grid, so I add an ID for the data grid component, and assign this grid's ID value to the target property of the component. Now, I plan to display three action items in the speed dial component, so let me define a speed dial items tag of type array that accepts n number of speed dial item definitions. Then, within the speed dial items tag, I add three speed dial item tags to display the three action items. Also, I need to add content to the speed dial items, so define the text property and set the values add to the first item, edit to the second item, and delete to the last item. See here, the speed dial component displays at the bottom right corner of the data grid, and when I click on it, the speed dial action items are shown. You notice that the action items are displayed only when the speed dial button is clicked. But you can also open them by hovering this button using the opens on hover property. Okay, next I will show you how to add icons to these action items in the speed dial component. Within this speed dial component code, I define the icon CSS property for these speed dial items and set the predefined classes eIcons and ePlus for the first item, eEdit for the second item, and eDelete for the last item. When I click the speed dial button, the action items display with defined icons and text. By default, the speed dial component will be positioned at the bottom right corner of the target element. But you can also place the button in other corners or at the sides. For example, to position it in the top right corner, I define the position property and set its value to the top right. You can see the speed dial button positioned at the top right of the grid component. Notice here that the speed dial button action items are displayed based on the position of the speed dial component. But you can open the action items in different directions using the direction property. To open them on the left side, I define the direction property and set its value to left. Here, I plan to show a tooltip for the action items instead of text. So, let me replace the text property with the title inside the speed dial item tags. When I click the speed dial button, the action items are displayed on the left side. And when I hover over them, the tooltip is shown. Also, notice that the speed dial action items are displayed in a list-like format, either horizontally or vertically, because the default display mode is linear. If I want to display those action items in a circular pattern, then I can use the mode property. So, I define the mode property and set its value to radial inside the speed dial component code. Looking here, the action items in the speed dial button are displayed in a circular pattern. Next, I will show you how to customize the radial menu using these properties: direction, start angle, end angle, and offset. I am planning to modify the offset distance between action items and change the radial menu direction. So first, I add a speed dial radial settings tag and set the direction property value to anti-clockwise to open the action items in that direction. Then, I define the offset property with value 50 pixels. You can see in the speed dial component that the action items are now shown counterclockwise, and the distance between the action items are reduced to the defined offset value. Next, I will show you how to customize the speed dial button style using predefined CSS classes. Here, I want to apply a border to the button with a transparent background, so I define the CSS class property and assign the predefined class eOutline to it. The speed dial button component is rendered with a transparent background with the border applied. Next, I will show you how to customize the speed dial button action items using an item template. First, I need to make the speed dial action items as child content, so I define the child content tag and add the speed dial items inside it. Here, I plan to display action items in different colors. So, I add an item template tag and define division and span elements within it. Now, to customize these action items with the custom class, I add the class attribute and set the value to item list. Then, using the context parameter, I assign the action items icon CSS class to this class attribute to show the icons in the template. Within style tag, let me add the background color for the action items and other CSS styles using the defined class. Looking here, the action items are displayed in different colors. Finally, I will show you how to bind the click event to these speed dial action items. To do this, first I add the item clicked event and assign the event handler, perform add action. Then, define this event handler that receives arguments of type speed dial item event args inside this code directive. Here, I am going to add a new record to the data grid when the add speed dial action item is clicked. So, I need to make a call to the grid method, addRecordAsync, within this event handler method. For that, I need to create a reference for this data grid component. And, using the data grid instance, I call the addRecordAsync method. When the addAction item is clicked, I need to perform the add operation, so let me add a condition to check whether the action item has the class, eIcons and ePlus. Also, I need to enable the allow adding property in the data grid. So, I define the grid edit settings tag and set the allow adding property value to true. Finally, I will set the isModal property value to true to prevent the background interaction with the target element until the action item is clicked. See now, when I click this button, a new row is added to the data grid, and I can fill that row with appropriate values. In this video, you saw how to create a Blazor WebAssembly app using Visual Studio 2022 and add a Syncfusion Blazor Speed Dial component to it. You learned how to add new records to the data grid using the item clicked event, how to set an add icon to the button, and how to customize it using predefined CSS classes. Finally, you saw how to position the Speed Dial button component. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.